out of Israel, man. So Israel, he's stressed out. He's concerned. That's why he want to wrap up everybody. He want to get everybody into his wicked wagon bending. He want to get everybody into his bandwagon. He want everybody. So because he know, he understood, they know that they're running out of time. He's so evil. Because watch this. As soon as he heard of Yahushua Mashiach, that the black savior, he was born, he like, oh my goodness, he was troubled. Why? Let's see. Because his father always seek to kill us. Right? He's nothing new under the sun. Let's read it. He said, when Herod the king, right, the so-called white man, okay, heard this thing, he was troubled in all Jerusalem with him. You see, that's the thing. When they hear that the so-called blacks, that, you know, and that's with the Israelite, that we're about to take the kingdom, they're scared, man. Everybody's scared now. All of a sudden, they say we're teaching hate. Because the Most High is waking us up, man. We didn't wake up on our own. No, who is waking us up? The Most High, man. The Most High waking us up. And guess what? The so-called white man, he's scared now. All of a sudden, they're scared now. Oh, they say we're teaching hate. Oh, we're spreading misinformation. Oh, we're spreading medical misinformation, blah, blah, blah. All type of weakness, right? Let's read it. Let's see what he said he's going to do. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, right? So he gets some coon. He gets the Herodian. The Herodian. The Herodian is like the way you said today, Democrat and Republican. Right, the so-called blacks and Latino that subscribe to be Democrat and Republican. Back in those days, they were called Herodian because they were following Herod. Right, it's same thing, nothing new under the sun. I understand that. So when you call yourself Republican and you call yourself Democrat, you are not different than our forefather that were Herodian. Same thing, Republican and things like that. I understand that. All right. So let us read it again. He said he demanded of them where Yahawashi should be born. He asked them, where is Amashiach, Christ, born? Where was he born? He want to make sure. So he gathered who? Some of the coons, right? They sell out. And they said unto him, in Bethlehem of Judea. For thus it is written by the prophet. Let's go to it. John 7:42. Let's break it down. John 7:42. This is the book of John 7:42. This is the book of John 7:42. Had not the scripture said that Amashiach cometh of the seed of David? So a lot of y'all there, you're talking about what? The virgin birth. There's no birth without what? The semen. Okay? Okay. Joseph slept with Mary. So Mary got pregnant. That's the only way somebody can have a baby. I understand that. When he's talking about she was filled with the Holy Ghost, it just means that the spirit of the Most High was on the seed, on David's seed. Understand? Because a lot of you out there in the Christian church, you're running around and you're talking about the virgin birth. Listen, you are a whore. In a Christian church, you're a bunch of whore. You know why? Because you're supposed to be a virgin. Understand that? So you need to fix that first. Before running your mouth, talking about the virgin birth, guess what? You make sure that ain't no man touching you until you're ready to get a husband. How about that? Before you run your mouth, you're talking about, are you virgin you yourself? Were you not pop when you were 6 years old, 7 years old, 8 years old? So keep your mouth shut, understand that? Mm-hmm. All right? Keep your mouth shut. Don't talk about virgin. You are not virgin, so this is not for you. Okay? It's for the righteous sister and the righteous of our parents that were taking virgin. Ain't no man touch them until they met their husband. What you got today in the Christian church? Boyfriend and girlfriend. Get out of here, man. That's weakness. Garbage. All right, so there's no such thing as a virgin birth. Understand that Mary, she was indeed a maid. That means she was a damsel ready to be given into marriage, right? So that's what the word virgin means. Okay, guess what? Joseph has sex with Mary. That's how she got pregnant. That's how she got pregnant. There's no such thing as somebody be born. No. This is what I'm reading. This cut your all your lying doctrine about virgin. There's no such thing. Show me that. I want to see. Call all your scientists to do that. Let them, listen, let your scientists get some women and let them not use the semen. Let them not use what we call sperma or sperm, right? And let the wife get, let the woman get pregnant. We're waiting to see that. Let's see that. We're waiting to see that. Do that and let us see that. Come on, man.
Then it would be man-made.
Right. Watch this. This is the book of John chapter 7, right? Let's read it again. This is the book of St. John chapter 7. We're going to read it at verse 42. Had not the scripture said that Yahweh Shai cometh of the seed of David, of the seed, the sperm, the sperm. So stop lying, buddy, right? The semen of David. Understand that. And out of the town of what? Of Bethlehem, right? Where David was. There we go, man. Because people don't understand. They're always, there is so much doctrine out there. So let's get back to it. He said, and thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art thou not the least among the princes of Judah? For out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel. That shall rule who? Yashala. That's why we say, Kwam Yashala. He's going to rule over Israel and over the remnant of the heathen Israel.